place number 12 on my top 20 fantasy mods list for medieval Total War Kingdoms. Hyrule Total War version 4.6. It's the latest release of the official mod Hyrule Total War by Undying Nephilim, its creator. And it's using more high quality models than the older version of Hyrule Total War. It's the original creator started developing Hyrule Total War back in 2009 and released his first custom battle demo in 2011, which I downloaded back then. And then he released the first campaign version in, I believe, September 2012, and then an update for it in December 2012. And I downloaded all his updates that he released like each half year, and he released another one during the summer of 2013, and then another one during the winter of 2013, and then another one during the summer of 2014, and another one in December of 2014, and that was the last version with the old models in December of 2014. Then in the beginning of 2015 he decided to remake all the rosters of the mod, so he remade them to look more like the official games known as Hyrule Warriors. And by the way, I believe Hyrule Warriors, made by Nintendo, were inspired by Hyrule Total War, so that's why I believe Undying Nephilim decided to honor that game by replacing the style of the old models with the style of Hyrule Warriors. So the old style was based on mostly the game The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, but also on The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask and Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, while the new version of Hyrule Total War was based on Hyrule Warriors, a game that was probably inspired by the mod. I believe Nintendo was inspired by the mod to make Hyrule Warriors. Okay, and I'm not saying that the style is bad or anything, but I always prefer the old side because I played Ocarina of Time back in the day, and I kind of like that anime style. But anyway, this is a highly impressive mod. It's placed number 12 on my top 20 fantasy list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms, and it has a campaign and it has custom battles, and almost all the Falcons have new models in HD. This means that they are more likely to lag in battle when you have huge armies, but also that they are of higher quality. So there was supposed to be a Hyrule Historia mode, but unfortunately the missions were never completed, and the Nephilim himself played a bunch of episodes on his YouTube channel where he played custom Hyrule Historia missions set this version of Hyrule Total War, but he never released any of them. Okay, but the Freeform campaign is playable. You have a bunch of playable factions, and we can go through them. We have the Kingdom of Hyrule, led by Tertullina Zelda V, Tertullina Noensen Zelda V of Hyrule, unlike in the old version where you played as Zelda 1. At the start you play as Zelda 5 in this version. You do not have the other Zeldas, so you only have Zelda 5 here. Then you have Link, the Hero of Time, and you have King Kazak, and you have Rauru, Sage of Time. So four heroes, completely in HD. In the old version, I believe that Link was in the game, but he wasn't added to the campaign, to any faction. And then we had General Kazak, and not King Kazak. So this mod is the version 4.6 version of the mod is set later. It starts at a later time in his lore, where he plays Zelda 5 during her time instead of Zelda 1. So instead of Kazak being General Kazak, he is King Kazak. Rauru the Sage of Time is the same character, and Zelda is a completely different Zelda. Link is older. He was younger in the original mod. Here he has a mustache and a beard. So he's clearly older in this version of the mod. All the other Zeldas have been cut from the mod. Okay, we have the Gerudo, led by Ganondorf here. And he looks different. I prefer the Ocarina of Time Ganondorf over any later Ganondorf. I always thought Ganondorf in Ocarina of Time was cool, and the old Ganondorf in old Hyrule War looked more like the Ocarina of Time Ganondorf. But in the old Hyrule War, you played as the Gyarados, led by Twin Roa, which is the fusion of the two wind witches, Kom and Kotak. But in this version, you have Ganondorf as the leader, Emperor Ganondorf. So he's not evil king here, but emperor. And then you have Kom and Kotak as separate witches instead of as a fusion. So instead of being one character, they are two here. And unfortunately, he picked the old versions and not the young. But this is a later setting, so that can explain why they are old. Then we have Naburu, of course. She's a hero in the old version too. So all the Gerudo heroes and the faction itself has become HD here. Then we have the Gorons, led by Darunia. And the entire Moblin faction has been remade instead of being huge colossus. I mean, huge giants in battle. They are mostly small children like Gorons in this mod. But there are some units that still are big, but all in all, I think the old roster was better in terms of style. They looked like giant masculine stone creatures in the old version, but in this version they look like smaller, like stone giant children. And if you ask me, it's more fun to play a faction of giant stone creatures than kids, in my opinion. But they look too childish here, but this faction has more modern models that are in HD, and he has added completely new heroes. Of course, Darunia is the same, but he's way smaller in this mod. We have this guy, Dangoro. He has been remade. We have Bigoron. He looks more childish here. And then we have King Ludungo. He's also remade. So compared to the old version, the models are more modern and in higher quality, but the faction has become more childish. We have the Sora's Domain, and they too have been updated. These models are really cool and stylized. I believe stylish, I mean. You'll have to excuse my English. But anyway, this faction is really good looking. I like the old one too. It still has the same leader, King Sora Farkas the Bon the 16th. And then they have Ruto, Princess Ruto, and Advisor Celine, and Priestess Tilara. So the same heroes and the same faction, but with a different style that I still think is very good. And that's the HD. This is the HD version of the Sora's Domain, Sora Dominion in this mod. They were just named Sora in the old mod, and Sora's Domain in Ocarina of Time, I believe. But anyway, which is the official game for the Nintendo 64. Okay, we have the Kokiri. They've also been remade, and they are one of the factions that have better looking style in this, I believe. Old style is still good, but the models here look way more beautiful. The female models, especially the blonde one, look way better here. We have heroes, we have the Deku Tree, we have the Great Deku Tree, we have Saria, we have Mido, and we have Mirora. So it's the same four heroes, but they have better models here. The only one I didn't like was Mido, because he is not as small here. He looks like an adult. So I prefer the old Mido, but everyone else looks better here, in my opinion. And then we have the Goma, led by Sylcaris, the Ugly. We have the Matriarch Giant Spider, we have Agita, and we have Evil Mido. Corrupted Mido. Okay, and I believe I preferred Mido in the old game, even for Goma. And I preferred Agita in the old game too, because she looked way more monstrous in battle. Here she looks more like an ordinary girl, to be honest. But the Spider and Sylcaris herself look better in this version. and the Goma faction itself is pretty much the same, but with HD models, so it's very similar. We have the Runa province with the same heroes, Mayor Bo, and we have Ilya, and we have which is a horse breeder for Runa. We have Raoul, swordsman of Runa, and we have Ashrei as a hero here. She was a mercenary for the Librina regime, the Kingdom of Hyrule, or the Runa province. In the old version, but in this version she has become a hero of the Runa province, and they have removed, I believe Andai Nephilim has removed the hero Anara, which spawns late game in the original game. The faction is very similar, but they have more goats and such in this version. In the original they had horses, in this version they have goats, and I think their models look better in this version of the mod. But the faction is pretty much the same in many ways, just with higher quality models. But certain heroes are changed. I preferred Ashe in Librina over in this faction, but she originates from Odunna province. But I like the Librinian look of her. Okay, where she has Librinian armor and such. Okay, but this is a HD version of the Runa province, and yeah, they're mostly the same heroes and such. We have the Lanayur province led by Queen Rutala here as well. We have Prince Rallis, we have Laruto, and we have Adia. So the same heroes, just in HD quality. But I prefer Queen Rutala in the old version because she looked hot in the old version, but here she looks like a general. Maybe this fits better for Hyrule War, but I prefer the hot version over the general version. Here she looks like a general. Anyway, the hot one looked exactly like the one in the game, the official game, Twilight Princess. She looked more like a civilian queen, while here she looks like a warrior. Maybe it's inspired by the official game, Hyrule Warriors, while the old one was from inspired by the Twilight Princess. Okay, so I prefer the old Rutella, but otherwise I think this faction is pretty much the same as in the old version, just with better models. So it's the same faction and the same heroes. We have the Deku tribes, led by the Deku King. We have the Deku princess, and we have two of the others, maybe Kado and there is a priest guy too. I don't remember exactly his name, so I will avoid saying the wrong name here. But they have the same heroes, and it's the same faction. And the Nephilim remade this faction 3 times. He released the original version of Hyrule War with one style, and he remade it for the faction because the models were so small that they ended up half their body beneath ground and such. Didn't look good, so he remade them, and the remade version is the one I am using in Classic Ultimate, a submod for the original mod. And then he remade them again for his new version with the HD models, and I believe the best models for the faction are in this version of Hyrule War. They look the best here, they look like the original Deck Tribes, Deck Scrubs. But with HD models and a lot of weird and cool creatures. So this roster is the best one. And the first one is the worst. And then the one I am using in the submod, they are the second best. Okay. But yeah, they were made 3 times, and in this version they have the best models. The Moblins, they also have HD models here. Led by King Ganon, they have the same heroes, King Balblin. And they have the demon, the mice, and they have this female moblin, I don't remember the name. Those heroes are all in the old version as well. Then in the old version they have Girahim, and they have, I believe, the demon version of the mice as well. But in this version they have fewer heroes. They do not have Girahim, and they do not have the demon version of the mice. Instead, they have the humanoid demon version, not the creature. But I think the HD version of the Moblins, they look too, they are too, what should I say, they look too friendly in my opinion. I prefer the Moblins in the old version, they look more evil in my opinion. But they are still good in this version. And the models are of higher quality. But the old version of this faction looked more evil, and I prefer the look there, to be honest. The Dark Knight Legion, their leader here is Salambar, God of Flesh, same leader, but he's just the official leader. Vat is the real leader. Then they have the hero Yraxanal, and they have the Black Knight, probably, or someone else, as the fourth hero. The faction is very much the same, but with better models, some new models and such. In the submod, I'm using a bunch of the models from the new HD roster, but not all of them, only the ones that fit. And I think the faction is probably better in this mod, in this version, but they, what should I say, they in the original mod, they were only infantry, they had no cavalry and they had no range units, but I borrowed some models from this mod that gave them javelin throwers and also some cavalry. They had one cavalry unit in the old version, but it was a two-legged cavalry called Masura, so pretty much a humanoid cavalry on two legs, but I gave them some cavalry on horses from this version. Okay, so this version of the Dark Knight Legion has better models with higher quality and more variation in its units. But in the submod Classic Ultimate, I'm using many of those unique cavalry and ranged units that we are missing in the old version, in the original old version. We have the Lizzelfoss, they have a new custom roster as well. They have the same heroes, we have Nadu the White, the Queen. We have Vakat the Winged, we have Okakusha the Green, and we have a fourth hero here, a Wolvegian hero that wasn't in the original mod, I believe. In Classic Ultimate, I've added Trinex, Lord of Turtle Rock, and Viorsot, Mother of Tyrants, to the submod. I believe in this version, Viorsot is a hero for the rebels or something, or a minor faction hero. Or might not even be in the campaign, but she is in custom battle because the model was from this game. And then Trinex, Lord of Turtle Rock, isn't a part of this mod, I believe. He had an old model for the old version of Hyrule to War that wasn't implemented. I implemented it to the submod. Okay, but this faction is in HD, like all the, most of the other factions of this mod. The 4.6 version of Hyrule to War, but they have a bunch of new units, and I think this faction is pretty cool. Probably they are stronger in this version than they are in the other version. They are very weak in the old version of Hyrule War. We have the Labrina Regime, led by Queen Ambi. We have Ralph the Engineer. We have Veran the Cunning. And we have the Mark III of Labrina, the Malevolent. So same heroes with HD models. One thing I didn't like was that Veran the Cunning was turned from a giant single unit entity to a ordinary character with a bodyguard of units. So in this version of the mod, she's an ordinary general and not a giant cavalry general. In the old version, she is a single unit entity that is taller than normal humans and much stronger. And the others, well, they have better quality models, I believe. I liked the look of Veran in the other mod better. She was hotter in my opinion, but I agree with updating the model. I just think that he should have kept the style of the old one. But I believe the reason she has a twilight skin here is because in lore, Veran was banished into the Twilight Realm, where she lived for a long period of time. And this mod starts after she has been in the Twilight Realm for a long time, so that's why she looks like a Twilight unit. So it's probably more correct lore But I always prefer the old model. I just think that model is a bit outdated when you look at it, and would have preferred it in HD. But I kind of disapproved of the change in style, you know. I wanted the old style with better models. The same style with in higher quality, so to speak. But I agree that it makes sense that she is a Twilight fairy now, after all those years in the Twilight Realm. And the others, so Labyrinna used to be based on like World War II steampunk. I believe the Falcon looked like a mix between three nations. Their personality and way of life reminds me of Nazi Germany, but their looks and colors seemed like a mix between Sweden and Nazi Germany. They have the colors of Sweden, blue and yellow in the old version, but the style, helmets and such, pants and such, and the lifestyle of the Germans from World War II, and then their music and architecture and buildings, etc., they are similar to the Soviets, actually. They are like Russians. Their architecture looked like Russian architecture. Their music was Russian-inspired, and also the Germans and the Swedes, they never had females in the army, while Labyrinna had both females and males, just like the Soviet Union. So I'd say the Labyrinna regime is a mix between the Soviet Union, Russia, Sweden and Nazi Germany, at least the old one. But in this version of Hyrule Total War, they have been changed, so they are more like a Spaniard faction from the Renaissance period. So they look like Spaniards in this version. And I never liked the change, because I liked when they looked like, you know, a mix between Sweden, Germany and Soviet. I liked the World War II style, but they are still cool, and they still have similar units. They have steam tanks, they have gunners, they have Tukey slaves, and they have similar swordsmen and such. The only unit that was removed in this version, I believe, was the mech, because Undead Nephilim didn't want the faction to be steampunk anymore, and wanted it to be more like a historical faction. He wanted to remove the steampunk from the faction, so that's why he made them more like the Spaniards of the Renaissance period in history, instead of like the World War II factions, okay, of Germany and Soviet and such, because they were a mix between Soviet, Germany and probably Sweden from the 18th century. Okay, we have the Fairies of Tarm. They have a completely new roster in HD with many different models. Some of the models have been added to the sub-mod, but for the most part they have not been added. And they have different heroes. We have the Fairy Queen, she was in the old mod as well. Then we have a new hero, Venus, I believe. And then we have the Essence of Tarm, an old hero, and we have a different hero here as well. No, this is Desire, and this is the Essence of Tarm. We have one new hero, Venus. But Desire looks very different here. She looks more like a monster. In the old version, she was more like a female. Looked better, in my opinion. But the Fairies of Tarm is vastly different in this mod. In this version of the mod, and all the models are in HD. So it's a different experience playing as them than if you do it in the old version. I liked the Mad Mystics in this version more. I added it to Samod because it was so good looking. Okay, but yeah, this mod has changed most of the factions, including the Fairies of Tarm. They have a new Stalfos faction too. They have new models. Many of the models have been added to my submod for the old version, but yeah, this is the HD version of the faction, and all the HD models in the submod came from this version. We have General Ekaso, or Undead Ekaso, as the leader still. We have a new hero, Azrael has become an undead hero in this version of the mod, that is set later. We have Starlord, the Giant Dragon, and we have Undead Onox, I believe. So all the heroes are the same except this one. which is undead as really. With a different name, I don't remember her undead name. And unlike in the old version, we do not have the same necromancy script, because Nep never re-implemented it. So they play more like an ordinary faction in this mod, unfortunately. We have the Freak Akadar, completely in HD. And now we have the new hero Freak, which is Zelda as a Freaka. I don't know how he reasoned here, because we have Zelda leading the Kingdom of Hyrule, so I don't know how she can be Freak at the same time. But yeah, I still like that they added Freak, one of my favorite characters from Ocarina of Time and Super Smash Bros. Brothers. Super Smash Brothers, Melee. Okay, so we have Lord Aghanim leading the faction. We have Impa as a hero still, and we have Bongo Bongo. And Srilli has been replaced with Freak, because she's now an undead hero of the Stalfus, as we saw. And this faction do not have the cool Shadow Stance, Battle Stance script from the original leader, because it was never implemented. We have the Kingdom of Kana, and it's unfinished in this version. It's using the old models, the same as in the sub-mod and as in the old version. They never got their HD models, because Undead Nephilim stopped this project and moved to Hyrule Conquest, which is a mod for a different game engine called Zero AD. It works more like Battle for Middle-earth or Age of Empires or Warcraft 3. So he decided to move the mod to a game that plays more like Battle for Middle-earth than like a Total War game. And when he moved in 2017, after the summer release in 2017, I believe 4.6 released in the summer, I believe when he, after he moved to Zero AD, he decided to never return to Hyrule Total War. And he left the Kingdom of Kana unfinished, unfortunately. So they still have the same models as in the older versions. Same with the River Sora, they have the old versions. Old models, so they are the same in the sub-mod as in this mod. And then we have the Order of the Visrob, they have a completely new roster. They look much better here, in my opinion. And they have Lana instead of Sia. I believe Sia is a later version of Lana, where she's evil and looks more, what should I say, she has like scars and such, a burnt face, and look older. And this version of Sia, Lana is a younger version. I kind of prefer Sia. But I added this version to the Hyrule Historia campaigns in the sub-mod, because she is the one in the Hyrule Historia videos. Okay, we have Karok and Nostrum, the same heroes as in the old version, but they look better here. The entire roster look better here. They are more detailed, more nice to look at. The only one I don't think look better is Hylia herself, the False Goddess. She is actually the hero in this mod. Well, in the old version she was the unofficial hero, and Nostrum, this guy, or this guy, I believe this guy, was the hero in this screen. So Hylia is the unofficial leader, but here she is the official leader, because she has shown herself. In the earlier setting she hadn't shown herself yet to the world. But in this version she has already come out of hiding. Okay, so Hylia has a better model here, but I think she looked hot in the old version. She looked more masculine here, so I prefer the old version of Hylia, to be honest. Okay, and then we have the Twilight faction, and it's also unfinished. In this version we only have the forces of the Twilight under Queen Midna. We do not have the faction of Sant. But Sant might still be a hero in the Midna faction in this version. So you have three old factions, the River Sora, the Kingdom of Kana, and the Forces of the Twilight. Okay, let's start the game as the Kingdom of Hyrule and check the map now. I've spoken a little bit too long here, because this video is about ranking mods in my top 20 fantasy list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. But I had to go through all the factions here to show the difference between this one and the other version, and to give some explanation on differences compared to in the old version of Hyrule Total War. it will take a while to start the campaign. Yeah, the map is new in this version, the loading screens are new. There are some old loading screens, but this one for sure is new. It's the new Zelda 5. Zelda 5 in the old version is completely different and is using a different model. I believe she's younger too, she's a kid in that version. Here she's still not an adult, but older. I prefer this model, it's much better. Much higher quality, but I didn't want to mix if I could avoid it. I kept the old version in the old in my sub mod because it fit better. But this version is clearly the superior model, and I still like it. Would have used it probably if it had fit better. So we still have the same pictures for events and announcements as in the old version, but we have a completely new UI. I kind of liked old UI better, to be honest. Looked better, in my opinion. We have new symbols for the factions. The Uka has been implemented here, and the Crusade feature, the cleansing feature, I actually ported it from this version to the sub mod. It wasn't in the old version, it was new for this one. All of these sages, the Council of Sages, were new in this version. I ported it to the old version and used the older pictures for all the sages, because the new ones didn't fit in the old version, of course. So we have a new version of Hyrule Prime on the map and in battle. I didn't want to use the new version in battle because it was there was less room for troops to move and such in the city. We have new buildings, so for the troop recruitment and such, but most buildings are the same as in the old version. It's just that the troop recruitment buildings are different here and updated. We have different heroes, as we saw. We have these four. I say this campaign is less completed compared to my sub mod, but compared to the 2014 release of Hyrule to the War, this version, it's a more impressive and bigger map. So the map has been remade. And it's more impressive here and bigger. You can see that Zebrosia has been removed from this area of the map. Instead we have the Sky City here. City in the sky, in an area where we can't go. We have a bunch of Uka priests here. Unfortunately we cannot go there. In the old version we had Zebrosia here instead, accessible through a general, which was a underground passage. That passage has been removed, and instead we have Andai Nephilim has added Zebrosia to the mainland. We have Exbo, and we have Exolin, and then we've added Zebrosia here actually. So he added Zebrosia to this area instead of on a different location and accessible through a underground passage. But the forces of the Twilight are still their own little area here. But they do not have any troops there. Instead the faction was moved here, because they work better if they started here. So this area is pretty much not in use by the mod. You can see that the map is much bigger, but it's still the same as in the old version, in the sense that it's still based on the old like blueprint for Hyrule to the War, but it's been vastly improved. It looks more detailed and impressive in ways. Of course in the sub mode I've made all the cities custom and such, so it still looks impressive and do not have any vanilla settlements and such on the map. But this map is bigger, the factions have HD models and such, so I'd say the campaign is less polished compared to the sub mode and such. That's why this one is ranked lower. But when it comes to the models, they have higher quality. When it comes to the map, it's a larger and more impressive campaign map. And when it comes to the the actual gameplay, this mod adds some new scripts and events that the old mod do not have. But I still think that the scripts in the old version were more numerous and more impressive. I believe Undying Nephilim planned to add all of that to this version, but never got to it because he was busy adding the new models for all the rosters, and he stopped when he had 3 rosters remaining, so he never got to the point where he would add all the scripts again. That's why this campaign in this version of Hyrule to the War is less completed than the campaign of the 2014 release of Hyrule to the War. And that version of the campaign was still more outdated compared to this version. For example, the Council of Sages, the new religions, I believe he added a bunch of new religions to this version that weren't in the old version. He added a bunch of new features and a bunch of new stuff. But I added most of that to the sub-mod, so... Okay, let's check the custom battle menu. We have a bunch of factions here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14. So we have 20 factions here. In the sub-mod we have 31, so it's not the same number, but we still have a bunch of different factions. The faction rosters. All in HD. Great models. We have heroes disabled and no mercs. We can have them enabled. We can check the true number of troops. We have all of this, a lot of mercenaries, a lot of heroes. Some of the heroes have not been updated, like Malin. She's still the old hero from the old version. Then we have new heroes like Haltor, Robber Baron, or Maxi. Elder of the Tempest. So these heroes that I added to the campaign in the sub-mod. Then there we have the Hyrulean hero, Zelda, Kazak, Link, custom battle. In the sub-mod I removed most of the humanoid heroes because I wanted more troops in the campaign. They took up slots, you know, when they were in custom battle. But we have most of the mercenaries and such in this version too. Okay. So we have a bunch of different factions. Labrina, for example, still has a steam tank, but it looks more like the Warhammer tank here, and is smaller. Looks more outdated compared to in the old version. I mean, the model is higher quality and more modern, but the tank itself looks more outdated, like it's from an earlier period in time. We have cannons. We have Ribaldur Queen. So I tried to add the Ribaldur Queen to the submod at one point, but I had a problem with the texture, unfortunately, because I believe that it took up a slot that wasn't used by the cannon in that mod, and when I believe the cannon and the Ribaldur Queen is using the same texture. So when I used the Ribaldur Queen in the sub-mod, the texture would be changed for the cannon as well, and it would look bad, so I didn't want it to use this texture. I didn't want to use this siege engine when it had the wrong texture, so that's why I removed it. Okay, but we have most of the units. They just look more like Spaniards here. Okay, I've spoken enough of Hyrule to the War 4.6, but to end my point, this is Hyrule to the War 4.6 with most of the factions updated, with HD models, a new campaign map, and many new scripts and features. But many of the old scripts have been removed because they were never re-implemented to this version. Nep never got to that point in development. He had to remake all the models, and he stopped when he had 3 factions left, and because of that, 3 of the factions are still outdated compared to the others, and all the old Hyrule Historia missions stopped to work when he changed the models of the factions, and he would have needed to update all the missions for him with the new modules, but he never got to that point. And the reason the scripts were never implemented is because he was not finished with updating all the faction rosters. Okay, but this is still an impressive mod. You can play it online or against the AI in custom battle. You do not have any Hyrule Historia missions, unfortunately. But you can play the campaign as the factions that I previewed, and still a very cool campaign, but it still has vanilla settlements in many places, and it's still not as stable as in the submod, and it's not as polished, so I rank it lower than my submod because of the fact that it's not as polished or as nor as finished, but it's still the I believe number 12 or 13 mod on my list. I think it was number 12, might be number 13. Anyway, this is Hyrule to the Wall 4.6, and I highly recommend you to try it out if you like fantasy mods and Hyrule to, and you like Zelda. Even if you don't know anything about Zelda, you should try it. If you like fantasy and you like medieval Total War Kingdoms. Okay, next mod.